Greetings, this is another video overview by the flashlight reviewer Selfbuilt. Before I get started, as always, just a reminder, please make sure you have annotations turned on for your YouTube player. I frequently update these reviews with additional comments or corrections, and those are done in little text caption boxes. So if you don't have annotations turned on, you may not be getting the most recent update information about the lights that I'm reviewing. Today I'm looking at the Eagletac G25C2 Mark II. This is a revised version of the G25C2 that I reviewed previously. The Mark II has been around for a little while, but I'm actually reviewing here in a slightly different emitter configuration. Just to sort of show you the light, physically not much has changed. Here's the Mark II on the left, and here's the older Mark I on the right. I have the optional diffuser cover on the head here, and I have a rubber tail cap, tail standing piece. But I think otherwise, if you look at the lights, you'll see they're very similar looking. Not much has changed other than you can see on the external, new label for the Mark II. Otherwise, it looks pretty much the same. There's a few internal changes, though, which I'll get to in a moment. The light, as always, remains to be a fairly robust build. You got decent knurling here, the tail cap on the body, bit on the head. There's a rubber grip ring that's removable. There's a pocket clip, also removable, with this metal grip ring cover for the pocket clip. One note about that, by the way, it has a tendency to unscrew, so you got to make sure that's always screwed tight, or it might block your tail cap from screwing down all the way. Less of a problem now than before, but it's still something to consider. You can tell from the overall build, it's a fairly decent sized light. It takes 1x18650 or 2xCR123A camera battery, but it has a fairly large head here, which will likely translate into a fairly decent throw, as you can probably tell there. It has a fairly deep and fairly smooth reflector on my sample, which will give you a pretty good throw. One difference on this one from the earlier model, and I'll just sort of open this up and try to show you, the emitter. This might be a bit hard to tell. The one on the left is my old model, and that was a neutral white. It's the warmer color. The one on the right is a cool white XM-L2. And that's the main difference. The old one on the left here was a standard XML emitter. The one here on the right, the new one I'm reviewing, is an XML2. You can't really tell on this one little sort of example. The XML2 is a revised version of the XML emitter, built a new way. It winds up giving it a smaller footprint, so a smaller die, which is more focusable for throw. You'll see some differences in the higher resolution scans of the emitter as well. The main point to this is to allow ultimately higher output bins to be produced. I don't know the output bin of this model, I just know it's an XML-L2, but it's probably at least as bright as the XML-U2 that you're used to for the light. So the main difference should be slightly greater throw, and ultimately greater output should be possible. I'm just opening up the light so you can see some of the internal components. This hasn't changed much from the earlier model, except I notice this is all now just aluminum, there's no brass as I had on my earlier model. You can see there's a button type 18650 cell there, which is important because there's a reverse polarity plastic piece around the contact point in the head. So only button top cells will work. Typically small button top or maybe the wider button top, but they have to be button top. They can't be flat top cells, so those won't work in the light. One difference here at the tail cap is the light no longer has anodized tail cap threads, which means you can no longer lock out the light. That's not exactly an improvement. I suspect it's to comply with patent rules with another manufacturer who owns the patent for tail cap anodizing. So that's kind of unfortunate, but it's just kind of the nature of the flashlight business. Otherwise, it looks pretty much the same. We'll just get that back on. The light functions pretty much the same. So let me just put it all back together here and show you what you're in for. So, as before, you have a forward tail cap switch. You can press for momentary and release, or press and click for locked on. You have a variety of output levels. The way I have it set right now, I'll just show you the way this works is you just loosen the head relative to the body, and as you can see, the light steps down to output. So there's actually four output levels. There's the lowest one. One up again, and then all the way up to high. Now that's how I currently have it set, with four defined output levels. You can switch it back and forth to a tactical mode, where you basically just have, instead of sort of a turbo, high, medium, low, you get turbo, low, and then two different strobe modes. Now you do that by doing turning the light off 20 times when in the second level. It's kind of a programming step, I'm not going to bother showing it. It's there if you want it, if you like to have that kind of interface. I personally prefer it in this kind of default. You also have a few other options, something else you can do. There are auxiliary modes, which just basically you just go from first to third and back again rapidly. This gets you into the auxiliary mode. So there's the first one, that's a strobe. Do it again, you get the second strobe. Again, there's a high flash. Again, you get an SOS, and I think there's actually two SOS modes. Then there's a beacon mode, and so on. There's a low flash and so forth. That's only if you do that rapid, you know, switch. If you just go slowly, you go back to being full output levels, you know, where you expected. It's a nice feature of the light. You can always kind of get it to come on where you want, just, you know, approximately by knowing how, you know, tight you want the head to be. The auxiliary modes you're unlikely to find by accident, but they're there if you want them, and you can just cycle through. Again, you can program the light to have a different set of, you know, standard output modes. You can also program the light whether or not it responds to a double click by going into strobe. In this case, I have that feature turned off because I don't particularly care for strobe. But if you wanted to have strobe, you could have it at the tail cap by doing that kind of double switch. I also have this light in kit form, which means I have with it the optional extras. This includes some battery extender options and some emitter option and some filter options for the top. So the way this works, as before, you can get these battery extender options. So you can run the light 2x18650 just by putting on the extra battery tube. There's an extra kind of grip ring here as well. And there's an anti-rattle feature for the smaller CR123A type cells that you could sort of insert between on the inside the battery tube update. So there's one to make it 2x18650. Here's a smaller one, which is actually probably when you would use this, to use 3x CR123A. With just a smaller extra add-on tube. The feature that I like about this model is the bezel ring option. So if we just take off the metal bezel ring, what you have here with the light is an optional, and there's an extra O-ring in there as well, is you have, with the optional kit, you have a screw-on type bezel with a diffuser, which is what you saw me use a moment ago on my old model. There's a little latch holding it in place. I find it's a bit actually stiff on this one. But what it does is allows you to, you can flip it up and run the light as you did before, just a slightly taller bezel basically. Or you can just flip it down, have it locked in place, and you get a very nice diffuse beam. Hard to see on the desktop here because it's too close, but it's actually very noticeable in real life, the difference between the diffused beam or the hot spot. So you can see there's the hot spot, and we'll just close that over, and then there's your diffuse beam. So this is a very nice arrangement. You can just kind of latch that close. You also have all the different types of colored filters to give you, you know, different appearances if you don't want to have just a diffuser cover. A very nice kind of option. I really like this sort of style. It's an all metal one too, so you don't have a, you know, a plastic one that might break down on you a bit more easily. A very nice arrangement. I typically keep my G25C2 always with the bezel diffuser cover on top, because it's nice to have that flexibility for throw most of the time or diffuse most of the time, then the option just to switch back to the other one. That's the main features of the light. Just to show you the packaging, this hasn't changed very much across the models either. So like before, you'll get as a warranty card. I also have a manual over here. If you can see, just kind of a standard manual that kind of goes through all the features of the light. That hasn't changed much. There was the usual kind of kit. You have a wrist strap, really decent quality, extra O-rings, that rubber tail standing piece I showed you a moment ago in the old model, glow-in-the-dark tail cap. You could switch to a tail cap boot cover. You could switch to if you wanted. There's also this type of standard kind of Eagletac belt holster with the metal closing clasp. You can push the light down inside, holds it fairly firmly, snap it together. This clasp also works if you put on the diffuser. It makes the light a bit taller, of course. It doesn't go in quite as far. And you can just use the outer clasp to hold it together. So a fairly standard kind of you know, basic kit that comes from Eagletac. Nice to have it for the light. A good all-around performer. And you'll see detailed specs in my review and detailed runtimes and testing about how it compares relative to the earlier model and to some other lights, you know, in this category. So for full details on the light and how it performs relative to its peers, please see my full review at Candle Power Forums, where you'll find me in the reviews forum under the username selfbuilt, or my personal review flashlight site at flashlightreviews.ca. Thanks for your time. I hope you found that useful.